Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
The weeds keep popping up in the Pittosporum. Poor plants don't have a chance to grow.
You could use a good herbicide instead of pulling the weeds with your bare hands.
Mm-hmm. And you could explore space on a holodeck instead of a starship.
Boothbit, tell me some more about Nova Squadron.
Not going well, is it?
No, it isn't.
You remember the Parisi Squares tournament of 24?
The final game against Minsk.
It took me 3 weeks to repair the grounds after the celebration.
We had a lot to celebrate. Our team wasn't supposed to win. We were very proud of them.
Well, the cadets today are just as proud of the Nova Squadron. The celebration they held after Nova won the Rigel Cup made 24 look like a dinner party. To the other cadets, the members of that team are gods, and that's a hard image to live up to. But Nick Locarno, he watches out for them. He keeps them together. Nick is what makes that team special. He's their coach, surrogate father, and best friend all in one. A natural leader. The members of that team love him. If he asks them to do something, they do it. Even if it means going right over a cliff.
Nothing conclusive. We do know that the collision occurred about 4 seconds after the satellite images were recorded, but we still don't know how the ships got into the new formation or why the crash occurred.
We unsuccessfully tried 53 different computational models in an effort to simulate the movements of the Nova Squadron just prior to the crash.
There are just too many variables to take into consideration. Speed, attitude, course.
Did Wesley's flight recorder indicate that there was anything unusual about the ship or the way it was operating?
The starboard power flow was fluctuating.
However, it was well within operational limits.
Fluidic pressure in the landing struts was low, but I don't know what difference that would make.
We did find that Wesley opened his coolant interlock just before beginning the maneuver around Titan.
That is a bit unusual. Normally, the interlock is closed unless you're performing a check on the engine coolant levels. But there's no evidence that Wesley was performing that sort of a check.
Filling the primary coolant tanks requires an open interlock, but that can only be performed in a maintenance bay. Is there any other reason for opening the valve?
It's the first step in purging the plasma exhaust.
That procedure would be extremely hazardous while the ship was in flight.
Yeah, the engine would probably ignite the plasma.
Ignite the plasma. That's exactly what they were trying to do.
I love beans. Woo, woo, woo.